Oh, Craig.
Happy anniversary. 16 wonderful years to the same man. That Hal is one lucky hombre.
Craig, you shouldn't have.
Oh, please. Special gift for a special lady on a special day.
No, I mean, really, you shouldn't have. Aren't only husbands supposed to give you gifts?
Fine, throw it in the trash then.
Oh, hold on. Well, let's see what it is first. Oh, look at, I've been meaning to try this color.
I know, I saw you eyeing it a couple weeks ago.
I didn't know we carried this brand.
We don't.
So where did you see me?
So, big plans for tonight? What are you gonna be wearing?
Oh, it's gonna be great. I have the most perfect red dress. It took me 2 months to save up for it, but it was worth it. Oh, I've been fantasizing about this night forever. Craig?
Say, Lois, you want to go catch a movie or something over lunch? They're playing my best friend's wedding over in electronics.
No, thanks, I don't...
Fine, forget it.
Circus! The circus is at our house!
Well, say goodbye for a few days, boys. We're moving out.
This is humiliating. Why can't we just stay at a nice hotel?
Because we're giving all our money to the exterminators so they can stay in nice hotels. Craig, thank you so much for lending us your trailer.
I'm just glad someone's finally getting some use out of it. I bought it 15 years ago to take on my honeymoon.
You were married?
No, I live on hope.
Well, thanks again.
You're welcome.
Bye. Goodbye.
You know, this is a little intense. You, me, working this shelf together.
What's intense about it?
I guess nothing. Excuse me.
Mom!
Not supposed to yell in the store.
Not supposed to do that either. Life's funny that way.
Hey, the three musketeers. Athos, Aramis, and you must be Porthos.
You're creepy.
You really shouldn't say hurtful things to grown-ups.
I'm sorry.
That's okay. We're still friends.
Craig, you have got to redo the nail polish. The crystal pinks are mixed with the frosty pinks or mixed with the God knows what.
Right away, Mr. Pitter. Lois will get through her operation. She is a fighter.
No. Craig, it was Francis.
Oh, my God. Did he shoot her? I knew it. I still told her to stay away from him. That boy has been nothing but trouble.
Craig, Lois did not have an operation. Our son Francis did. See, she just went down to Alabama to look after him for a while.
Oh. Tell Lois I stopped by.
Craig!
I just brought by your mom's paycheck. Tell her I'm the one that brought it by.
Wait, we need your help. My dad's going crazy. He hasn't slept in 4 days. He's smoking. He's dancing around in his underwear. He's ripping phones out of the walls. You've got to stop him.
Don't worry, son. I'll handle this.
What are you doing?
You don't expect me to tackle something like this on an empty stomach. Hey, buddy.
Well, well, who do we have here?
The boy here says you could use some company.
No, I got my sons. We're bonding.
What the hell is that thing?
That thing is a little project we have been working on around here. A secret, deadly project.
Hal?
Why don't you turn off the machine and sit down?
Why don't you stop telling me what to do?
Why don't you sit down like I asked you to?
Look, Fats, I don't want you around my house anymore.
Hey, you don't go to the fat thing, I won't go to the crazy thing.
Dad, cut it out!
Come on, it's not funny anymore.
Hey, Uncle!
No!
Just say it! We can stop this right now with a little dignity if you just say it!
I won't say it!
One simple word!
Dunkle.
You said dunkle. Now you have to say uncle in my butt.
Don't let me up!
Dad, you have to
stop
it!
You're
right. I've got better things to do.
Dad, what are you doing?
I think me and Lois number two here are going to go down to work and pay a little visit to Mr. Jackson's Lexus. Hey!
Dad, don't move.
What are you doing?
I'm stopping you from quitting your job by threatening you with a killer robot. I wish it felt half as cool as it sounds.
Just turn it off, Malcolm.
Stop being crazy.
Just put the remote down. Okay, you have no idea what this machine is capable of.
Why don't you just sit down?
And why don't you just put the remote down?
Dad, please.
Malcolm?
Why'd you both just shut up?
Run. No kidding. Run. Oh, no.
Animal control.
You ripped the phone out of the wall.
Go to the neighbor.
They won't let us over anymore.
Do something.
Why don't we just all sit down and no one will do anything until Mom gets home?
Okay.
Lois!
Hi, Craig.
What are you doing here on your day off?
Oh, I just stopped in with the boys so they could buy me a birthday present.
Oh, it's your birthday? I'd completely forgotten. Seems like any other day, actually.
Yeah, well.
Craig, dial 7. Craig,
of course, you can't blame me for forgetting. I've been so busy lately. Seems like I'm always hitting the weights at the gym, working on the guns.
Craig, dial 7.
Yeah, and when I'm not at the gym, I'm usually with my Dixieland jazz group.
Really? What do you play?
I'm the costumer. You know, there are 4 different types of straw hats. And if you ever need those arm garters...
Craig, I can see you.
Bye.
Oh, you've got to help me on this. I can't believe that you could be so thoughtless. We all screwed up really big this time. I have a good mind to use the belt on all 3 of you.
Why are you yelling at us?
Sorry isn't good enough, mister. I forgot your mom's birthday. No! No! What? What? What?
Hi, Hal.
Craig, what do you want?
Well, Lois and I had an exchange, and I felt bad, so I'm sure she told you all about it.
No, actually, she didn't say anything. Now, Craig, we're in the middle
of it. Well, it's complicated. You see, I didn't buy Lois a present, even though I wanted to. I thought, this is silly, so I went ahead and got her one, and... here it is.
Oh, great. I'll take it into her right now. Oh, such a nice, nice gift.
You know what? Second thought, I can take care of this tomorrow. I'll bring it into work.
Oh, no, it wouldn't be any trouble at all.
Really?
No, I'd be happy to take it into her.
Yeah, I'd really hate to put you out.
Don't be silly.
Your present! It's a bread baker and I paid $129 for it!
Honey? Honey, where are you going?
Wherever I want.
Well, when are you coming home?
When? Whenever someone in this family gives a damn.
Here. Shouldn't you be in military school?
Shouldn't you not be in my father's robe?
That is neither here nor there. You are in big trouble, my friend.
I'm in trouble?
Yes, big trouble. I'm telling your mother.
No, I'm telling my mother.
That's my toast.
We'll split it. Can't believe this. I bought my own bus ticket home. I have to spend the whole weekend with you.
I hear you. It's a shame you had to spend your own money. I've discovered a way you can travel for free through the internet.
What, you hacked into an airline's reservation system?
No, that's illegal. I go into a chat room and pretend to be a really hot 18-year-old girl. I'm Debbie. I'm blonde, naive, and I love to wear sundresses. Right now, I'm having a lot of problems at home. Dad's so mean. Going through all these changes, all these strange new feelings.
The free travel?
Right. Debbie goes into some chat room, gets real friendly with some lonely guy. Before long, he's willing to pay for a visit. Right now, I'm sitting on a ticket to Tampa. Oh, and I make sure he buys Debbie full fare coach, no restrictions. She may look good in a thong, but she's no dummy.
Wait.
I see. Nice try. What's that supposed to mean?
Miseric. It's another military term. You know, the helmets that horses wear.
Oh, right. This is nice. Hanging out on a Saturday, playing Scrabble. A couple of guys relaxing. So your folks get along okay?
What?
Nothing. Here we go. Read it and weep.
C-A-T. Hey, that's two cats for you. That's great.
Just playing the tiles I'm dealt. So, you pick up any bad vibes here on the home front, you let me know, right?
Why?
Hey, take it easy, cowboy. Just making small talk.
Okay. I guess they're doing fine.
She's a strong little lady, that mother of yours. Sure, we have our moments at work, but you can't stay mad at that woman for long.
You don't have to live with her.
Maybe you just don't understand her.
What's to understand? She's a total control freak.
Maybe she doesn't get the support she needs here at home.
Well, I wouldn't know since she sent me to military school.
Because you're a spoiled brat. And I'm pretty sure Miseric ends in a K. Hi, Lois.
Oh, hi, Craig.
Notice anything different about me?
Nope.
Just got her in today. Craig Feldspar, assistant manager.
Congratulations, that's great.
And along with the red badge, as you know, comes an extra 2% discount. Which I'm more than willing to share with you, Lois.
Oh, no, Craig. That's your discount.
Really?
I wouldn't feel right about jeopardizing your position by taking advantage of that. I wouldn't feel right about it.
But what good is all that power if I have no one to share it with? Teresa, would you mind checking out aisle 4? Seem to have noticed someone knocked over the candy rack. And could you put the coffee toffees on a lower shelf?
Okay.
Did you see that? Did you see that resentment? Isn't it wonderful? Look at me. I'm shaking. Everything is gonna be fine. Just fine and dandy. Yeah, keep waving that thing around, buddy boy. You got a big surprise coming.
Craig, that button has been disconnected for over a year.
What? Why?
Because you kept hitting the damn thing.
In an emergency, yes, that's what it's for.
Oh, like an emergency when you saw a bee? Oh, when you saw the big fly that looked like a bee? How about when you thought you saw a ghost?
I'm not saying it was or it wasn't, but you can't tell me what we saw was normal.
All right, you two, let's move it.
He likes waving that around too much. This is gonna end at body bags.
No, Craig, it isn't.
Lois, before we die, I have to tell you something. It's about how I feel.
Craig, no.
But Lois...
Craig, no! This will... Everybody just stay calm.
And don't make any sudden moves, or they'll kill you. And don't look them in the eye, or they'll kill you. And don't beg them not to kill you, or they'll kill you.
I need you to stop talking.
You! Assistant manager, come here!
This is it. I didn't feed my cat. Isn't it funny the things that go through your mind before you die?
Craig, they just want to talk to you.
Lois, before we're all killed in a bloody mess, I have to tell you...
Shh! Let's not think those negative thoughts. Let's just give them the money and get them out of here. Hey, is there any way we can speed this along?
Yeah. Somebody can give us the combination to the safe.
Fine. I can't, but the assistant manager can. Craig, give them the combination to the safe.
No.
What?
You can't have it.
Yes, they can. Craig, give them the combination.
Let me talk to them.
What's the combo?
You feeling better?
Yeah, I think so, thanks.
Good.
Now tell me the damn combination!
No.
Can I talk to you for a second? Listen, fellas. I want to get this over with as much as you do. So why don't you give me 5 minutes with him? I guarantee you I will get that combination for you. Listen, Craig, I think these guys really mean business. Now you know and I know there is less than $700 in that safe. Do you really think the lives of 7 employees is worth less than $700?
Lois, this isn't just about the money. Sometimes a man has to have his dignity. So what if they kill me?
But before they kill you, they're going to try to get that combination from you any way they can. Can you picture yourself with shattered eye sockets? Because that's where they're gonna start. They can break every one of your fingers and toes, and they can even cut a couple of them off. Did you see the buck knife in the big guy's boot? Do you really want to antagonize that big buck knife, Craig? Do you really want to feel it slicing into your flesh? Craig, stay with me. Stay.
Oh, no. I heard something.
Knife at them. I never saw anything like it. The guy's a hero.
Hey, did you happen to see the most beautiful girl in the world? And if you did, was she crying? Hey, did you happen to see the most beautiful girl that walked out on me? Tell her I'm sorry. Tell her I need my baby.
Oh. I'm sorry, what?
Your total is $6.24. Is there a problem?
No, it's just that your assistant manager and I, we have an arrangement.
I wouldn't know anything about that.
I've only got $3.
Well, you can put back the magazine.
Lois, I give Officer Stockton a discount. You know, policeman's discount, 100% off.
Craig, I can't do that.
But Lois...
Don't worry about it. That's okay, Greg.
It's Craig. What, are you crazy? Don't you know how this works? We scratch his back, he scratches ours. We give him a few candy bars, he looks out for us. It's called protection.
Craig, we have been robbed 5 times in the last 6 months.
Lois, think of all the places he gets free stuff from. He can't be everywhere at once.
Hey, do you know where Craig is? Your assistant manager, big guy, smells like cabbage. Thanks.
Uh-uh. It's not there. Keep looking. Lower.
Craig, Mom said you can give me a ride to study group.
Sure, sure.
What are you doing?
I was reviewing some old security tapes. You know, looking for a pattern, see if anyone was casing the joint. You can't be too careful.
Hey, that girl's stealing something.
Oh, I didn't notice that. I'd better review her other tapes then.
Wait, are there cameras all over this place?
Oh, yeah, they're everywhere. Pharmacy, ATM, the bathroom. Yep, a lot of cameras.
Is there one in the parking lot?
Whoa!
What is it?
That girl dropped a can under her car. Sorry.
Wait, stop, there's our van. She did it. She's guilty.
Where's Lois? Did I miss her?
Craig.
You guys are not gonna believe what I have. I have a surveillance arrangement with the manager of the mini mart across the street. We exchanged tapes in order to better understand the security needs of our customers.
Short skirt, windy day?
That's code. Anywho, one of their cameras caught Lois from a different angle right before she got her ticket. See? Lois was right all along. This completely exonerates her. Isn't this great? What are you doing?
You will never, ever tell her of this.
But,
ever.
Got it.
Kitty's at the end of an ear infection. He'll need drops 3 times a day. Now, Jelly Bean likes to have a half cup of wet food in one bowl and a half cup of dry in another. Now, he likes the juice from the wet half poured onto the dry. Now, no overfeeding. I mean that, mister. Okay, maybe tomorrow. I can't say no to you.
Craig, can we speed things up? We've got Jelly Bean's emergency numbers. We know where his sweaters are. You showed us how to take his temperature. Is there anything else Dewey needs to know?
Guess that's it, sport. Now, taking care of another living thing is a big responsibility. Are you sure you're up to the challenge?
Mm-hmm.
Don't worry, Craig. I have a feeling Dewey's gonna do a great job.
Great. And when the long weekend is over, you'll have earned $5 whole.
You told Mom 10.
Right, 10. Aren't you a good little listener?
Ow! I'm not so sure about this, Hal. Are you sure that Dewey can handle this?
Ah, it's no big deal, honey. A job is a good thing for a boy. Teaches him the value of money, gives him a little self-confidence. Besides, Craig's new place is only 2 blocks from our house.
Hey, you can see our backyard from here.
Hey! I almost forgot to show you my itinerary. Yeah, the convention lasts 3 days. I'll be back early Monday evening.
Wow. Craig, I had no idea you were so into comic books.
Well, it's not like I'm a freak about it. It just helps me keep my life in perspective. You know, somehow my problems seem insignificant when compared to Richie Rich's. Well, it's time to say goodbye, Jelly Belly. Come give Daddy some kissy kisses. Come here, give me the kisses. I love you. Yes,
I do, do, do. I know, son.
Yes!
No sign of forced entry. I just don't see how these guys got in.
It's a mystery.
You left the window open.
Mystery solved.
I'm sorry, what is it you say you're doing here again?
We're watching the cat while the owner's away.
I don't see a cat.
We're not doing a very good job. Hello?
Hal?
Oh, Craig! Hi! How's the convention?
Fantastic. I picked up some great bargains.
You would not believe some of the idiots that are here. Anyhow, I just called to see how Jelly Bean's doing.
Oh, fine. He's a frisky little guy, you know. Oh, get off the TV, Jelly Bean.
That reminds me.
Could you hit the timer button on my VCR? I want to tape Arliss.
Sure. No problem.
Hey, Hal, I want you to think I'm weird, but
Did you put Jellybean on the phone?
Yeah. Let me just pick him up here. There he is. Okay, I got his ear to the phone.
Hey, Jellybean.
How's my little pussycat? Have you been a good boy while I've been away?
I love you, honey.
Give Daddy a kiss.
Jellybean?
Mom wasn't too thrilled about having to pick us up at the police station, but it was totally worth it. We don't have to serve Francis anymore. Here's your sandwich, Craig. Can I go to bed now?
Ooh, mayo on only one side?
It's a lot of mayo.
No one's saying it's not, but I specifically asked for it on both sides.
Craig!
Malcolm, I don't like this any more than you do, but it was your mom's idea. Since as long as I'm living here, you have to do everything I say, I'll try to meet you halfway and make my orders as clear as possible, okay, champ?
Here, I heated it for 10 seconds, just like you said.
It's still not quite room temperature. Look, I know I'm being demanding. Jellybean's apartment was burned down, too.
All right, it was almost worth it.
5 minutes.
God, I hope I get it. I hope I get it. How many people does he need?
How long is he going to be living with?
Look, we have to be patient with him. We burned the man's house down.
How many boys? How many girls? How many people does he need? Look at all the people. At all the people. He doesn't like the way I look. He doesn't like the way I dance. He doesn't like the way I...
That's it. We're opening the door. Someone go get me a coat hanger.
I did that yesterday, Dad. Trust me. Don't go in there. He's done when he's done.
Hey, everyone. Say good morning, Joey Bean.
Oh, dear Lord.
We burned his house down.
You know, I'm really excited about this father-son weekend at Marlin. Spend some time with Francis, do some male bonding, maybe even a survival hike.
You have your fluffy pillow?
Right here.
I'm really gonna miss you.
Oh, come with me.
I can't. I'm not allowed. It's fathers and sons only.
Well, I'll hide you. No one will know. You can be my dirty little secret.
Now, this is nice. And don't you worry about a thing, Hal. I'll take as good care of your house as you did mine. I'm just kidding. I won't burn your house down. But that's all in the past, totally forgotten. I better get going, though. Don't want to be late.
Thanks. Bye, honey.
Bye. Lois, I'm aware this isn't the most comfortable situation here, having me around all the time, the forbidden fruit, as it were, especially now with Hal gone.
Yeah, Craig, it's not...
But whatever feelings we shared, that's in the past. That part of us is dead now.
Craig, I...
Let's not rekindle them.
Hey, Lois! Fight for the time!
Craig, I have to work late tonight. Would you mind feeding the boys?
No problem.
Thanks.
So, I'm in charge then?
All you have to do is fix them some dinner.
Right. But I'm completely in charge. They gotta listen to me.
Dance for me. That's right. Dance. Why? Because I'm in charge. That's why.
We burned his house.
Ready!
That is so cool. I wish you had a gun so we could really test this thing out.
Excuse me. Can I get some help here?
Hey, Craig.
So, I overheard your mom talking on the phone, and it's true. You've got a job. I applied here once. Didn't get it. It's all politics.
I guess. So what do you want?
I want you to listen very carefully. My blood sugar is dangerously low, so I don't want to burn up any calories repeating myself. I want the jumbo clown burger with the big top fries. No pickles. A slice of onion, make sure it's center cut, and extra tomatoes. And let's do the patty well on one side and medium on the other. And make sure they open a fresh package for my bun. If it's stale, I bail. Seriously.
Total's $5.45, and you get free refills in the soda.
Heard that one before. Turns out it's just for today.
What a sack.
That's a pocket transaction if I ever saw one.
Oh,
Yeah. Right.
I had to move a couple dozen bags of charcoal briquettes, but I found the slightly darker blue one that you wanted. I got a few spider bites, but none of that matters as long as you, the customer, go home satisfied. You're welcome.
Excuse me. Where are your dog toys?
Yes, ma'am. They're right there, right behind you.
Those are leashes.
If I could direct your attention 3 inches to the right.
I want that little hot dog up on top.
Sure thing. I see we have one just like it right here.
That isn't what I asked for. This has mustard on it. Peekaboo doesn't eat mustard.
Well, I can see the one up there has mustard on it, too, and since it's not even real mustard...
Are you going to give me what I asked for?
Certainly. There you go. Thanks for shopping, Lucky Aid.
This has mustard on it.
That's what I tried to tell you, you old bat! Now you're gonna take it to your dog and make him like it!
Now let me drive!
How's it looking? Welcome! Welcome! I can't hear you! You're not watching without me, are you? Whoa! Malcolm! Malcolm! Please, dear God, I know I haven't been a saint, but I swear if you...
Hal, what are you doing here?
Well, you're off work in 5 minutes, and I am here to whisk you away for a night of romance.
Oh, honey, that's so sweet, but I can't. I've got a cover for Craig tonight.
Why?
Oh, he's sick as a dog.
Come on, you know that guy's the biggest faker in the world. The last time he was out with the flu, we saw him jumping up and down in the window on the Today Show.
That doesn't mean I wasn't sick. You didn't happen to tape that, did you? I set my timer wrong.
Oh, honey, I'm so sorry. After all the trouble you went through.
No, it's no big deal. Really, it wasn't any trouble.
Thanks again for the ride home.
Wow.
So this is what it would have been like to go to my prom.
All I wanted was a nice evening with my wife.
I even dug up the wedding vows I never was able to read to her.
What happened?
Well, she went into labor with Francis in the middle of the ceremony. I was going to read them to her tonight.
God, now I feel awful.
Don't worry about it, Craig. It's not your fault.
No, I really feel awful.
I know someone's home. I saw shapes moving on the curtain.
Marshmallow, guard.
Hey, Sport, is your dad home?
No, they went to a restaurant, but they said you should go over.
Well, I just came to drop off some pants. They got out...
Craig, help! Help us, please! Dewey's gone crazy. He's holding us prisoner.
I'm sorry you had to see this.
Number 12. His twinkling eyes.
Pinky and Evil were dumb and sarcastic, while Dewey, in contrast, is super fantastic. That's why Dewey is king.
Why Dewey is king.
Hey, it's haircut time. Think of your favorite stooge, and I'll be right back. Marshmallow, if anyone moves, eat them.
This is insane. We've got to do something.
I'm Mo.
We don't have a choice. I say, at the count of three, we split up and all run for different doors.
Are you nuts? He might get one of us.
Yeah, but two of us will get away and go for help.
I'm willing if you are. I can't sing anymore.
Ready? On three. One, two, three.
Go, 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 go!
Craig's a good guy. He always comes through for us.
I couldn't find any rusty cigarettes.
It smells good. Took you long enough, though. What'd you have to fly to Italy to get it? Never mind. Let's dig in.
Hot.
Let's just let it cool down a little bit.
Hot tongue blistering. Please, God, no. Water.
Good monkey. Closer.
My milkshake ready. It was supposed to be ready an hour ago. If it's warm, you could go ahead and drink it, because I won't.
I just love this, too.
All right, I will. Where is it?
Setting up perfectly.
Oliver? You know what? I've changed my mind. I'm not in the mood for a milkshake anymore. Well, since you did go to all that trouble.
Again, look at the height.
You in there? Craig? What happened? Behind you.
What the hell's wrong with that monkey?
He's crazy.
Well, he picked the wrong guy to mess with.
Oh, no, God, please, no!
Hang on, Craig!
No, leave me! Save yourself!
I'm not gonna leave you, buddy! You'll be safe here! Ow! Ow!
Not my Romulus!
Shit, anything like this. Take that, you damn.
Isn't this interesting? Once more, I'm the only person that can help you. I'm your best friend when you need someone to pick up your mail or sit on a suitcase. But when it's time for a barbecue, I have to watch from the car. I gotta tell you, Hal, this beer is tasting mighty bitter. I'll take another.
Are you going to help me or not?
I will help you. But one day, and that day may never come, I will ask you to perform a service for me. Actually, it'll be tomorrow. I'll be here about 10, and if it's nice, wear a bathing suit.
Yes, I'm looking for a serious graphic novel with cinematic drawings and neat linear storytelling.
Weren't you in here the other day?
No, I don't.
Okay, look, I just want to buy a present for my son, okay? I don't think that's a crime. As I see it, my only crime is not knowing as much as you. Look, you all have parents, don't you? I am appealing to you as decent human beings to help me give my son a happy birthday.
Hey, man, I'm sorry. I guess we did kind of get off on the wrong foot. We all got to start somewhere. This one's called Dead Man's Shoes. It's $50.
Ooh.
It's all about alienation. I think your son will really like it.
Thank you. Not so fast.
This transaction does not concern you, Feldspar.
That's Craig Feldspar. He's a level 45 dungeon master.
What cereal box did you shake this out of, Dean?
It's the first print. It's totally collectible.
Oh, should we check the Overstreet? Wait, we don't have to. 1997, first and only printing. 50,000 returns, all in circulation. I'd keep this in my bathroom, but not for reading. This isn't a comic book store, it's a novelty shop.
Oh, really? Well, I'd like to see the novelty shop that carries an original Spider-Man number 14 with the first appearance of the Green Goblin.
You're kidding.
And if you change to a more respectful tone, it just might like...
What are you doing?
Fear not. It is the 1993 reprint. If it had been an original, he would have thrown himself in front of it.
Dude, you told me that was real.
Now, let's talk business.
Craig, I can't thank you enough. That was fantastic. You were so heroic.
I like to think we all have a little bit of Aquaman right here.
Well, I must say, you really know your stuff. I'm impressed.
Well, you know, if you're interested, there is a convention next Saturday.
I have a life, Craig.
Never leave. Whatever's worse. It's your choice, pal. I think you're gonna like this.
Yeah, yeah, I get it. I put it in my mouth, your toenail clippings are in it, I spit it out, and you've got it all on video. It's been done.
I'm so sorry about that. But we've both grown up a lot since then, and I have a proposal I think you might find interesting. It's still warm. Now, I know a hip guy like you keeps up with the current music scene. It's awfully short notice, and you're probably not even available.
What are you talking about?
There's a concert this Saturday, and Allison and I were wondering if you'd like to go.
You want me to go to a concert with you?
Yeah, pretty much. But the real fun part is the drive there and the drive back. But I don't have to tell you, right? I mean, look who I'm talking to. A single, middle-aged guy with a cat. You know all about the dating scene.
Well, sure, that's my rep, but...
I mean, it's not like you're even excited to go out on a real date. It's not like it's something that you'd be bragging about for weeks.
Well, of course not. I mean, who cares? But if people were to ask, I'm not forbidden to tell them, am I?
Not at all. This is going to be great.
And you say I can tell people, right? Look, I've only got 2 minutes. A woman thinks I'm looking in the stockroom for a humidifier. Now, I want you to listen to this tape and tell me whether you think it's better to go ELO Kansas Doobies or Doobies Kansas ELO. I'm not telling you which one I'm voting for.
What are you talking about?
The mixtape for our date. Didn't you get my emails or phone messages or the notes I left under your door?
You know, I have a lot of homework to do during the week, and I can't really spend...
Look, just listen to it tonight and get back to me with your top four choices. Now, what do you think for a shirt? I like the blue, but I'm worried the open collar look is a bit racy.
You don't have any pants on.
That's what these are for. I want you to pick your favorites separately, then we'll decide what goes together.
Whatever.
I am going to call you a million times before Saturday. I haven't been this excited in years. Now I know why people look forward to weekends. Teen, I got my first velour shirt, and everything changed. Suddenly, there was an opening in the astronomy club. People started sitting on my side of the bus. But I'm a Libra, so I like to think the best of people.
So, Craig, I was telling Allison how well you focus on your driving.
No, you were just telling me that if I really loved you, I'd let you get under my...
So you guys like to take long walks on the beach? I sure do. Plus, I'm a grandmaster at Battleship. I've got the hat if you'd like to see it. So, Allie, do you have any brothers or sisters? What do you think you're doing? You don't talk to me, you just start kissing? I am a person, and I deserve some conversation and some of the social niceties before the kissing starts.
You know what? I was okay when he pulled over twice to change his shirt, but I really don't think he should be yelling at me.
Okay, don't freak out. I can handle this. My family kind of owns it. You know, Craig, another thing girls really like is the strong, silent type. Craig, you just passed the concert.
Oh, no, I don't think so.
But there was a sign, and it had an arrow, and we're supposed to follow the pointy end.
Oh, come on. There's other fun things we can do. I thought we'd start with a hayride, and then a light dinner at Cicero's. I've already tipped the violinist to drop by our table, for the lady. Then I thought we'd cap off the evening with a nice romantic bonfire at the lake.
Craig, you are ruining our date.
Now listen here. Do you know how long I have dreamed and planned for this night? 34 years! And I am not gonna let you little brats ruin it! We are gonna have a hayride, a dinner, and a bonfire, and this is gonna be a magical evening that will live in our hearts forever!
What's that on your glasses?
What? Ah! Oh my God! Reese! You said she'd be nice to me! You said she'd like me!
Yeah, let's ditch this loser. Okay. See you at school.
This is great, isn't it?
Alice is nice, but I have to say, I think a date's better with just two people.
Can we stop calling this a date?
Well, whatever it is, I can't wait to see the look on my neighbor's face when I come strolling home after 11. Eat your heart out, Mrs. Clevisall.
I think I just missed my curfew.
There are no curfews on a night like tonight.
Here I am, the one that you love, asking for another day. Understand, the one that you love, loves you.
Okay, I'm gonna do a load of colors, then a load of white, so if you have any clothes in your room you want...
Craig's been over here every day helping out with the chores since Mom went to her sister's. It was 2 weeks before we figured out, but nobody asked him. So Dad's in charge.
Ow!
Boys, quit horsing around and eat your dinner. Hey! Stop! Now we are at zero tolerance now! Do you hear me? Zero tolerance! You boys have got to learn to behave! From now on...
Who wants more mac and cheese?
All right.
That is it! Sit down! Just because your mother isn't here is no excuse to misbehave! Now when I just had the worst dream. The boys just... I lost control of them, and you were never coming home, and it was just awful.
It's okay, sweetie. Go back to sleep. We'll spoon, okay?
Okay.
Kicked him out of the house?
Oh, please. He kicked himself out of the house, Craig. Look, I've been through this before with Reese and Francis. It never lasts long. When Reese was kicked out, he spent the night on the roof until he got into a fight with a pack of cats.
So that makes it okay that Malcolm spent the night sleeping on a booze-soaked mattress in some dark alley?
Craig!
Oh, my God, he's probably dead by now!
Malcolm can take care of himself.
You're right, he's a genius. Which would make him even more attractive to rogue elements in our secret weapons programs. How long before some government scientist picks him up and tries to surgically attach him to some animal?
Oh, this better be good. There'll be hell to pay if Jellybean wakes up from her massage and doesn't see me on the table next to her.
Oh, my God! Is that an Ortair?
It's a Nortair 680B. It's like the first personal computer ever made. You have an interest in this type of stuff, don't you?
There aren't many of these left. I'll give you $5 for it.
Yeah, right. I checked online. This is in mint condition. It's worth at least $1,300.
Deal. No takebacks, double black magic, tap it, bomb it, flush it down the toilet. You understand it's going to take me a couple days to get the money.
That's exactly what I want. I want you to buy it this Saturday at our garage sale, in front of everybody, with cash. You're going to react in horror when I tell you Reese was going to throw this in the trash. And then you're going to tell everyone they should have listened to me all along.
You know, right now you're sounding a lot like a James Bond villain.
Me? There's nothing wrong with me. I'm fine. And right. And on Saturday, everyone's going to know it.
Okay, but these revenge plans have a way of backfiring. Word to the wise, if you ever make someone an Ex-Lax milkshake, don't do it on an empty stomach.
So you have the money, right?
Yes, it cost me 3 Little Lulus and a Captain Picard plate. I hope you're happy.
I'll go get the computer. You memorize this script.
Follow me.
Excuse me, Malcolm. It's me, Craig. What's that you're holding in your hands?
You mean this thing that I've been trying to save, that Reese has insisted all along was mere junk?
Mere junk? Why, your brother couldn't be more wrong, nor you more right. Please allow me to buy it from you for the princely sum
of... Come with me. Oh! Dad, what are you doing? Craig, get back here! Mom, what are you doing with that? I ordered you to throw this away! Let go of it, you idiot!
Get it? Quite the fun-filled weekend ahead of us. Tomorrow morning, there's jazz at the farmer's market. Then Lifetime is having an intimate portrait of Sandy Bullock. And tomorrow night, there's improv in the park with a political bent. Sound fun?
I think I just want to play.
Play? Well, sure, we could squeeze in some play, I guess. Why don't you go ahead and get that started?
No, I mean play together.
What do you mean?
We can play Fort.
Ooh, I don't have Fort. I have Clue, but it's a collector's edition, unopened. If you want, I can show you a picture of it.
No, you don't have to have Fort. You just do it. Didn't you ever play Fort with your friends when you were a kid?
Of course I played. I had friends, plenty of friends. And you're short.
Come on, I'll show you. 99, 100... Ready or not?
Here I come. There you are. What's wrong?
No one ever found me before.
It's because you're such a good hider.
Yeah, that's probably.
Are you sure I'm not too old for Winky Dinks?
The box says for ages 8 and up.
Well, I'm right smack dab in the middle of that window.
What the hell is this?
Shh! We just got them to go to sleep.
You boys aren't even supposed to be here, and you're throwing a co-ed slumber party?
Who's the fat chick?
Okay, that's it. I want everybody out of here, pronto!
Hey, no one tells us what to do.
Sure. Craig, you might want... None of your excuses. You and your little friends are in a boatload of trouble.
Let's just go back to Craig's apartment and wait it out till Sunday.
We can't just leave him here.
Dewey, there's a principle I learned in military school. The needs of the many outweigh the needs of the guy who can't run fast.
No! We face painted each other. I'm not leaving him here.
Dewey, there's nothing we can do.
Not the Kravis doll!
No, this is just what you need. Remember? Job, people, a life.
But why here?
Because this is the only guy I know that would trade a job interview for a Hong Kong food lunchbox.
Greetings, Earthlings.
You've got to be kidding me.
Trust me, I know it's gonna be hard, but if you can just keep your mouth shut for 5 minutes with this guy, you're home free.
I'm waiting, Princess.
My resume?
Forget this. You can't learn anything from a resume. So, tell me about your employment history.
Well, I...
Interesting. You know, I like to think of Lucky Aid as a kind of family. And in this family, I'd be your father. And as a father, there might be things I might ask of you that don't make sense, but you do it because I'm your father. No sassing back. Just do it. Understand?
I think so.
Now, who are you in this family? Are you the second cousin? Or maybe the kooky aunt?
Well, you know, I've always kind of seen myself in the role of the younger brother. Eager to learn.
I never had a brother.
Almost an hour. He even made Leonard follow him into the bathroom. But Leonard's tough.
Now, let's talk about respect. Not self-respect, but respect for one's superiors. Now, I remember a time, think quick! It's just a little management test I came up with to see whether you're the type of person who confronts problems head on or avoids them. Which one were you? Good. And I see that you have no spine. Welcome aboard. Come back in an hour, we'll get you a trainee vest and a name tag.
Congratulations, I knew you could do it.
Oh my God, that guy's an idiot.
You only had to do an interview with him. Try having dinner with that jackass and his stupid cat.
The cat can't be any stupider than this guy. This moron just tried to use a Barbie doll to explain the hygiene procedures.
Brother, huh? I think I'll stay an only child, thank you. Doc, Doc! Lois, I need to borrow a coat hanger. I dropped my sandwich underneath my car seat. What's going on here?
Lois is in labor and Hal's not here.
I have dreamed of this moment. Here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna carry you in my arms to my van. I have one of the three original sirens from Starsky and Hutch. I can make that trip in 7 minutes flat.
You're talking crazy.
There were only two sirens used in the entire series, and they're both in the Smithsonian.
Au contraire. There were four sirens.
I believe it true.
Okay, clothes for babies, names for babies, truck drivers dressed like... Ew.
Excuse me, can somebody help me find Malcolm's...
Six months, maybe a year.
I'm gonna need that computer.
Not today, Squirt. Lois is about to have a baby, and I'm in charge of research.
She's hot.
I cannot work with someone looking over my shoulder!
Well, I'll see if I can...
Hey, Craig.
When will J-Lo learn? Take it from a bad boy, we're nothing but trouble. You're buying the Tidy Winks.
Yes, and I'm in kind of a hurry.
I don't want to criticize, but I think I know why you're buying the Tidy Winks. It's the absorbency, right? People always fall for that. But what they forget is the elasticity of the legs is suspect at best.
Craig, I just...
You know, since I'm kind of little Jamie's unofficial second alternate godfather, I've been doing some research, and I recommend you take a look at the baby naps. They've got this polymer-based fabric that not only has remarkable wicking capability, but actually...
Craig, for God's sakes, I'm in a hurry! Now, I just want the Tidy Winks, okay? I don't have time for a big discussion. Now, please, will you just ring me up?
Certainly. That'll be $7.98.
Craig, don't make a thing out of this.
Why, whatever do you mean, Hal?
I'm sorry that I snapped at you before, but I really need these diapers. Can you loan me the money?
I could loan you the money, Hal, but that would be helping you. And since you have a tendency to yell at people who try to help you, I don't think that's the wisest course of action for me to take.
Look, Lois will pay for these tomorrow when she comes in.
You can't take those, that's shoplifting!
Fine, then I'm shoplifting. What are you gonna do about it?
Vermin! Oh, look ashamed.
Can I at least have a phone call to let my family know where I am?
Well, technically, you're not under arrest, so no. But since we're friends, I'm going to allow you to work off your $7.98. 2 hours of minimum wage ought to do it. As a crust, I have to have it scraped off by...
Just get her...
Eventually. But until then, the only thing that's stopping your father from smoking six packs a day is knowing that we quit together.
But you didn't quit.
But he knows I did.
But you didn't.
He knows I did.
You lie and you smoke.
Oh, for God's sake, Malcolm.
Lois, I just remembered you were holding my lit cigarette in your hand. And I wanted to thank you for holding onto my cigarettes, which are mine.
He knows.
Okay. I think I left my register open. Don't get too down about this probation thing. This job is mostly a beauty pageant.
You know what's weird? You get used to thinking of a person as being so much more powerful than you. Then something shifts and it becomes kind of awkward.
Oh my God, are you my boss now?
What?
This is so unfair. Year after year, why can't...
It's nice to see one of the good guys win. Once you take a load off, I'll go get you a cup of joe. No worries, Chief. I don't know why you won't let me help you with that, Lois.
Craig, please, I really don't want you to.
Why not?
Because every time you come in contact with me and my family, something horrible happens to you. I can't deal with the guilt anymore.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Come on, if it weren't for us, you'd still have all your teeth. You wouldn't flinch every time you saw a ceiling fan. Your car never would have been filled with bees.
Coincidences.
Craig, you broke your foot looking up a phone number for me.
Please, Lois, it's Christmas.
Here. Maybe you can fluff up the cotton on Santa's beard.
Thank you.
Ow! Oh!
Ah! Oh my God!
Honey, is that you?
What is going on here?
Good news! We did it! We made a profit!
Really? How much?
The numbers aren't important. A profit is a profit.
Hey, look! A squirrel.
What?
There he goes.
Squirrel. Gone.
Craig, we will catch him. All right, here's the deal. This time, it's $10 each and one item from the medicine cabinet.
It's gonna be tricky, fellas. We're on his turf now.
Go, let's go! And you better be wearing a cup.
I know you've heard the rumors, and all I can say is I might or might not have been scouted by the Kyoto Crazy Phantoms. But don't worry, I play for Lucky 8. Now, watch me carefully, because I only work at one speed. Lightning.
This one's for you, Malcolm! Try again! Here's another one!
Is she crazy? How does she expect... Craig, that was amazing.
What were you expecting? I told you I was good.
Ollie, are you okay?
Fine. I just seem to be having an out-of-body experience, which my shaman would be very proud of, but I think I'm gonna be falling down now.
Oh, I've got you, baby.
He's here, Angel.
You.
Boys, please, please. Now, every conflict invites a dark angel and an angel of light, so let's summon an angel of light.
I have waited for this moment.
Not as much as I
have. How do you know how much I have?
Abe, come on. No, Hal. He's made a fool of me for the last time.
Craig, don't do this.
I will not stand by and let him put the horns on me, Lois.
Something weird going on in that boy's brain, and I, for one, want
to
know.
One feet dance to the happy groove time!
Tell the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours, damn right. It's better than yours, I could teach you. But
excuse me.
Craig!
Oh, hiya, Hal.
What are you doing?
Just protecting my high score. Cheaper than a gym, and no shower bullies.
You're great!
Oh, hell, I'm kind of a legend around here.
You're staying out of the ball pit, right, Feldspar?
Yes, sir, you were quite clear on that. Hey, hop on up, Hal. It's a blast. Beat it, Davey.
It's
the boogie
happening! Come on, it's easy. Just watch the screen, put your feet where it says.
Let's try it. This is fun! Really fun!
Oh, God. I just got him to stop the ice sculpting.
You're doing it! And it only took all my lunch break and $200 worth of quarters.
Can't one of you have a heart attack so the rest of us can play?
In a second. Showtime!
Yes!
I think we're finally ready. I didn't want to say anything until I was sure, but I signed us up for the weekly tournament.
No, it's too soon.
Hal, you don't work this hard just to jump dance alone in your room? Besides, someone has to teach Haley and Kylie not to be so stuck up just because they think they're so great.
You can't enter the tournament. You're going to look like idiots.
We're not done rehearsing. We'll be a lot better by then.
No, you're going to look like idiots because it's a contest for kids.
It doesn't say that anywhere. I read the rules 3 times. And we're under the weight limit. You can call the manufacturer.
10 messages from Dewey's counselor. Maybe I should...
practice so we could win this thing?
Right. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and four. And boogie, shake, and slide, and slide. These jazz shoes have really helped my kick turns. Totally worth $150.
Hal.
Uh-oh, here comes Yoko.
It's 5 o'clock in the morning. You've been up all night.
Honey, I know you think this is silly and that I've just gone off the deep end again, but this isn't like the other times. I have a gift, Lois, and it would be wrong for me to turn my back on that.
Right. I see we've entered phase 2, which is fine as long as you follow the rules. You have to go to work. You have to eat. You cannot involve the children.
And you're freezing the joint account.
Did it last week. Good night, Fred. Ginger.
I thought it was Fred and Barney.
Court iron, so I had to schedule an emergency lesson with the golf pro. The guy charges like $90 an hour. It's really eating away at my savings. But I guess I have no one to blame but myself, and oh my God, you know about the affair. Damn it! Damn it! You do know, right?
Yes, I know.
Damn it!
Craig, how could you lie to me after all I've done for you? I let you sleep on our floor when you thought your cat's ghost was trying to kill you. I settled that feud between you and the Girl Scout troop.
They started it.
Shut up! I do all this, and you repay me by making me drag around 50-pound sacks of dog food so you can sleep with the boss's wife? That's inexcusable!
I didn't plan this. It just happened. One night after inventory, we stopped in the parking lot to talk. I bent down to pick up her keys. The next thing I know, she's got me handcuffed in a shower in a motel out by the airport. She's crazy, Lois. But she makes me crazy, too.
Craig!
I'm not kidding. There is a dark, scary place inside of me that I didn't even know was there. But Paula knew it was there. And every night she takes me to that scary place and shows me some new, terrible, delicious corner of it. You're not gonna rat on me, are you?
No, but you have to end this. Today.
I can't, Lois. I'm addicted. I don't even know who I am anymore. I know I've let you down, but I want to thank you for helping me anyway.
Craig, I never said I'd...
If that homeless guy is still in the dumpster, just let him drink for the hose.
Can't you cancel your lesson?
I wish I could, but we're working on the Texas two-step tonight.
We never see each other anymore. Lois, I see you more than I see my wife these days.
Oh, Fred, things have a way of changing for the better. You'll see.
Attention, Lucky 8 shoppers. My name is Craig Feldspar, and I have a message for Paula Lynde. Paula, I can't go on like this. I'm going to do the right thing and make you my wife.
Are you hearing
me? I just bought an $11,500 engagement ring, which I hope you'll accept.
You're cheating on me with Craig Feldspar? I think we're both victims here, Fred.
I had to work today. That's nice of you.
My pleasure. Hey, gee whiz, you know who I haven't seen in the longest time? Your boys. I think I'll just drop in and say an innocent hello. Hey, boys, what do you say? The four of us have a giant tickle party. Okay, that was just a cover. I didn't want to alarm your parents.
What's going on?
I need you guys to teach me how to fight. There's this jerk who's always picking on me, and I'm sick of it.
Why are you asking us?
Because this guy's stronger and faster than me. The only chance I've got is if I fight dirty. And let's face it, your family's legendary for that.
Well, people exaggerate.
Please, you've got to teach me everything you know.
I don't think that's such a great idea. I mean, I teach you some tricks, you teach them to someone else, he teaches them to another guy, and sooner or later, I'm in a fair fight.
Sorry, Craig.
What am I supposed to do? I came to you guys asking for help because that's what I thought friends do for their friends.
Dude, calm down.
I thought we meant something to each other. I mean, after all these years, after everything I've done for you...
Craig, stop it.
I can't help it.
Okay, I guess we can teach you a few moves. Just stop crying.
Really? I mean, you're not just saying that? You'll teach me how to fight dirty?
Yes, but you're gonna have to fully commit to this. And you need to know that once you start training with us, you're gonna see the world differently.
And there's nothing we can ever do to restore your innocence.
Thank you so much. You guys are the best.
You hug me and the lesson starts right now. I'd like to welcome you to the first day of your new, more vicious life. I give you the human body. For clarity, we've divided it into the 3 major theaters of operation. The head, the torso,
And what are those?
You know what those are. Now, the first thing you need to know is that this is all about pride. Do you have pride, Craig?
Yes.
Okay, that is not the answer I was looking for. You show me a man with pride, and I'll show you a man with limited options. Let's say that this is your opponent, and he's coming after you. Hey, man! We can work this out! I didn't know she was your girl! See? Now he's blind, and he had the time to really get creative. Personally, I like to leave at least one sense intact so he knows what's happening to him.
I knew I came to the right place.
Okay, Dewey. You're up.
Okay. First, I'm gonna need you to take off your glasses.
Oh, my eyes! I didn't know we were starting!
There is no starting in dirty fighting. Life is one big fight from the day you're born to the day you die. Okay, maybe we should slow down a little.
Time out! Time out!
I think we're wasting our time here.
Let's just kick him in the kidneys and call it a night.
No! Please! I know I suck, but I want to be better. Please, I'll try harder, I promise!
Let me try something. All right, Craig, listen. I want you to think. I want you to visualize every bully that ever picked on you or beat you up. Really see the look of contempt on their faces as they pounded on you. You got it? Now, picture what they were looking at.
Oh, it's disgusting! Ah!
Is he going for the plums? It appears so. Virgin always will be.
22. But that doesn't mean you can't enjoy the heck out of every moment. Take tonight. You're in for a real treat. There's a different rhythm to the night shift. It's a camaraderie, a brotherhood of kindred souls, a nocturnal fraternity of the prowlers of the inky netherworld. Hello, fellow traveler.
Where's the toothpaste?
I'm on a break.
Make sure all the pens are cap side up with the pocket clip facing forward. This is the benefit of graveyard shift. You don't have all that chaos that goes on during the daytime. You can get things organized the way they're meant to be.
You're just trying to torture me. That's why I'm here. Just admit it.
You're here because you need the money.
I give you 3/4 of my paycheck.
That's why you need the money.
That's weird. Did you see anyone?
What?
Someone left a candy wrapper and change on the counter here, but nobody's been in the store for hours.
It was probably a mouse.
A mouse that left the exact change?
I played tic-tac-toe with a chicken at the county fair, and it beat me 8 times in a row. Don't shortchange animals.
I didn't see anyone, though. Craig, take a look at this.
If you don't mind, I'm trying to get in a quick nap before my break.
Seriously, check out this guy. He's here, and then 2 hours later, he's still there, only in a different outfit. And 3 hours later, he shows up again in another outfit. Whoa! Did you see that?
Malcolm, please! If I don't get my 16 hours, I'm a bear!
Oh, Craig! I'm so sorry. Why didn't you tell me you were planning a party?
You know? Oh, Lord, this day just keeps getting worse.
Oh, Craig, this is all my fault. I feel just awful about this. I'll do whatever it takes to make this up to you. I'll even... Oh, hold on a second. Hello?
Mom, it's an emergency. You gotta come quick. Something horrible happened.
Hello, Dewey? Dewey!
Lois, if you could just get the ropes. My hands are wet. I think my wrists are bleeding.
Happy anniversary, Lois. I chewed through my rope so I could have this set up for you before you got back.
Oh, Craig.
I invited the entire staff, but I guess they didn't show up on account of seeing me as human garbage.
I wish you'd be mad at me. Yell at me. Tell me I'm a horrible person, please.
Don't apologize, Lois. If you want to make me happy, just sit down and enjoy your party. Hello, everybody. Here's one I'm sure you'll all remember.
Here she comes now, our Lois Lewis. Strutting down the aisle like she doesn't know us. Hey, she wears a smock and she looks all right, yeah. You got scared and stuck and mocked the cat shell. Meow, 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 yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. she's been here 10 years. Through the laugh, through the tears, punching in, punching out. Said that time she had gout. I said, yeah.
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 I'm sorry, ma'am. I can't sell you that box. It's damaged.
I don't see any damage.
Thank you for choosing Lucky Aid.
Craig, I need you to cover my Friday night shift. There's a Lifetime movie I want to see. Heather Locklear is a welfare mom trying to get her kids back.
Friday?
I wouldn't want you to miss that, Lois. I cried my eyes out at the part where...
Shh!
Right, we'll talk later.
Craig, how could you let her do that to you?
I would have totally spilled the romance with the hunky social worker.
No, why do you let her push you around like that? She didn't even ask. She just assumed that you'd have nothing better to do than to pick up her crappy shifts. That's not right. She does this all the time. She takes advantage of you without any consideration of your feelings. Doesn't that upset you?
I guess I am a little cheesed off.
There you go. I knew you were too much of a man to let her get away with this. You're gonna show her that Craig Feldspar can't be pushed around.
Thank you, Malcolm, for opening my eyes. You've awoken a sleeping giant, and he's very cranky.
Hey, how you doing?
Hi, how are you? So, Craig, did you tell my mom that you couldn't cover a shift Friday night?
Oh, I think I did. We'll just have to see. Okay, America, get ready to meet Craig Feldspar.
Craig, are you all right? Craig! Craig!
Kit, is that you? It's helped me back on my hog. I'll be fine. Thanks, I'm good to go.
Oh, Craig, don't be ridiculous. You're not going anywhere.
Why? Do you need somebody to paint your lawn or mow your house?
Look, Craig, Malcolm told me about that. I admit I take you for granted sometimes. I apologize for that, but we could talk about that later. You have to come back.
I can't.
Why, Craig, come on. Aren't you interested at all to see how my mom punishes me?
No.
Why not?
Because for the last 12 years, I've dedicated my life to a relationship that can't exist. I can't go back to that.
Craig, what do you want from me?
I want more.
I'm sorry. I can't give you more. You know that.
There's got to be something. There's got to be some scenario where you could see us together. Please, anything.
Okay, this is the only universe this could possibly exist in. I'm 90 years old. Hal is dead. I have dementia, and I need someone to keep me from catching myself on fire. There's no money for a nurse, the kids won't do it, and I'm asleep 22 hours a day. Then, and only then, maybe, could we be together.
It's like you're reading straight out of my diary.